So let's return to our memory management subsystem. And of course, the whole idea of objectization of the memory management subsystem, or any subsystem for that matter, is to increase the concurrency for system services that we're going to offer for the threads that are executing on the processors. So in the memory management subsystem, the main service that we're offering is the page fault service. And let's say that in this example, there are two threads, T1 and T2. Let's assume that they've been mapped to the same processor, which means with the objectization that I described to you, they are sharing a process object. So if T1 incurs a page fault, it's going to go through the process object to the region that corresponds to this particular page fault. And now let's think about what needs to happen in order to service this page fault. We might do hierarchical locking. So for instance, if I want to do some modifications to the region object to indicate that I'm modifying the data structure that corresponds to this portion of the address space, I might say that, well, let's lock the process object, let's lock the region object that it corresponds to, let's lock the FCM object that is backed by this region, and let's lock the COR object that is actually going to do the I/O for me. If I do this, and now let's say the operating system is incurring a page fault for the second thread T2. And let's say that this page fault, because it is happening on the same processor, it shares the same process object. But maybe this page fault is not for this region, but it is for a different region, let's say region 2. But if we have locked the process object in servicing this page fault, then we cannot get past this process object because the lock is held on behalf of servicing this particular page fault. And therefore, the operating system cannot process this page fault, even though you may have multiple cores on the processor and these threads are executing on different cores of the same processor, you don't have the concurrency that you wanted. So this hierarchical locking kills concurrency, and that's a bad idea. So what you don't want to do is do this hierarchical locking. But it seems like in order to service this page fault, if I want integrity for these objects, I want to be able to lock the critical data structures. But if the path that is taken by this page fault is different from the path that is taken by this page fault, why lock this object in the first place? So we don't have to lock this object because the path taken by the page fault service is different from this. And so hierarchical locking is a bad idea. It kills concurrency. But you do need integrity of this process object. And in particular, if the reason why we lock this process object is in some sense to ensure that this process object doesn't go away. How can it go away? Well, one of the things that can happen under the covers while page fault service is happening, there could be a decision to migrate a process from one processor to another processor. And if that happens, then the process object may be migrated. And that's the reason that you have to worry about the integrity of this process object. When something is happening that is going to modify something in this process object, you don't want this process object to go away. That's actually to do with existence guarantee. So what we're going to do is we're going to associate a reference count with the object. And rather than do hierarchical locking, what we're going to do is put an existence guarantee every time this object is being used. There's a reference count that is associated with that. And the reference count is a way of guaranteeing the existence of this object. So let's come back to this example again. So if T1 has a page fault, it first goes to this process object before it goes to the region object, because this particular page fault is going to be serviced through this region object path. But it is not going to hold a lock on this object. What it is going to do is, it is going to increment a reference count for this object, saying that this object is in use, please don't get rid of it. And subsequently, if this page fault happens, access the same process object, it's also going to increment the reference count. It is not going to lock this object because its path is different. It is going through this path in order to service its page fault, which is for a completely different page. The whole point of having this reference count is now if, let's say, some other entity in the operating system, such as a process migration facility, that says I need to balance the load on this multiprocessor by moving some process from this processor to a different one. If it looks at this process object, it'll say, well, I cannot touch this process object because its reference count is not zero, which means that this process object is currently servicing some requests locally. And that is the way we can ensure the existence guarantee for this object and integrity of this object, and that can allow us to get rid of hierarchical locking and promote concurrency for service activities that can be provided by the operating system for the same service, but where there is concurrency that is possible. In this case, page fault service that can be happening in parallel for independent regions of the address space, touched by the threads that are running on the same processor, but executing on different cores, perhaps, of the same processor.